Hey, it's Shade. Welcome to this channel. Today's video, I'll be trying out the Dior Backstage Foundation on my skin. I'm just seeing like if it matches and how it looks, and I have it on right now. So I will be applying it fully for the first time in this video, and I will be also trying out some other new Dior products as well. If you are new to this channel, please make sure you click that subscribe button, give this video a thumbs up, and let's get into it. So in this video, I will be trying out this Dior foundation, and this is called the Dior Backstage Face and Body Foundation, and this is in the shade 65N. So I was actually sent this foundation from influencer. If you guys don't know what influencer is, and you're like a beauty YouTuber or wannabe beauty YouTuber or beauty blogger, like, I suggest you find out. It's a great way like to get like free like beauty products to try. A lot of like the things I get to try, I get through them, they get sent to me for free, and this is just one of the things. And I'm really excited about this because like this is like my first like luxury like high-end foundation, so I was really excited when I got like the email saying that like I was selected like to get to try this out. And also like a few products from this collection, which I also got this Dior Backstage Glow Face Palette and this Dior Mascara, which I've been trying out for a while now and I like it a lot. And this Glow Palette is basically a glow palette, and it has like different colors. It has two glow colors and two like blush colors basically. So I'll be trying all those things out in this video. I wasn't sure that this foundation shade was actually going to match because I selected the foundation shade and like the survey they do before they send you out things, and I just saw like the shade on the computer, so I picked what I thought would be the closest match, and luckily I think that it's going to be an okay match. Like, it's always hard to tell like in the bottles like the shade of foundation if it's going to work or not, but you know, we'll see. I did test this foundation out a little bit, but it wasn't like, I didn't do like a full glam face or anything. I just did it like on part of my face, and it looked pretty okay. But today in this video, I'm gonna just do my whole face so I can get the full picture of it, so that you guys can see how this foundation looks and how this shade looks on my skin. So this is how the top looks. It's kind of like a squeeze kind of top. And it has like, the hole's like a pretty like decent size. With my Fenty foundation, like I can just like squeeze the foundation like on my face. So with this, I'm just gonna try just to go like, just to squeeze it out. Hopefully it doesn't spill. Like, it is kind of liquidy, so yeah. And I'm just gonna put some on this side. So I'm scared that it's gonna fall like on my shirt and mess up my shirt, which I really don't want to happen. I'm gonna put some in the middle. And over here. And this has a smell to it. I can't really explain this scent, but it has like some kind of like fragrance to it. It's not like a bad smell, but it definitely doesn't smell like nothing. And before I get started, I did use this Rimmel London Stay Matte Foundation Makeup Primer, and it is like my go-to primer. I absolutely love it, and I think it's really great for the money. I think it was like $7 or something like that, so it was really well priced, and I've been using it like so much, and it works really, really great. So far the foundation, like, it's applying pretty well. Like, I'm not having like a hard time like spreading it or anything like that. And as I'm putting more on my face, like, the smell of this foundation, like, it has kind of like a floral scent to it. It reminds me of like a kind of perfume that has like a flower scent. I think that the shade of this is like spot on. It looks really, really good. And I was kind of nervous about that just because like in the bottle, like, it's really hard to tell like the color of this, you know, like compared to your, well, actually it does look kind of close now, but like before I had any of the foundation on, like, it was harder like to tell. Okay, so I am finished putting on the foundation, so I'm going to go ahead and just finish up my full face with The rest of the Dior products. I am using this new Dior Show mascara that was sent to me to try, and I like this mascara a lot. Like, it's like really, it has like a nice like thickness to it, because I feel like it sticks like to your lashes better. So next I'm going to apply this Dior Glow Palette, and it has four different colors. It has these two colors right here, which are for like the highlight, and these two colors, which is supposed to be like the blush. I think I'm probably gonna use this color right here. And this is my favorite brush to use for highlight. And I can see it now, it's coming up, but it's kind of like, since it's not a powder, it's kind of like soft. It's not like, it's not picking up great on this brush right now, which is kind of annoying. So I don't know like what kind of brush like would be better to use for a highlight or a kind of like a pressed powder like this. Okay, so it is showing up. I hope that you guys can see that like right here. Like there's just an extra like bling kind of like going on right there. It's like not as like intense as like I kind of like thought it would be, but that may be because of like the brush that I was using. Like on my mirror, like I can see it like more of kind of like the bronze in the highlight a lot more than I can see like on camera right now. To finish off this look, I'm going to use this lipstick and this Hollow gloss. Now I am so excited about this gloss because I was eyeing this for a while at Victoria's Secret just because I thought that it was just like really, really cool. And so I bought it because they had a sale for buy one, get one free for their beauty products. So I'm like, this is my perfect time like to get it and try it out. And before, like I was applying this by itself, but it does say that this is like a lip top coat so that I guess you can apply it like on top of like a lipstick. But I mean, you definitely can like use this by itself also. But I wanna show you guys like what it looks like. So this is the gloss, it's kind of like a purple iridescent kind of like sheer color, but it just looks so cool in the light. Okay, so that looks so much better. So it's like this cool kind of like purple periwinkle color. It's so pretty to me, like especially like in the jar. So hopefully it looks as good on my lips. I don't want it to get inside and mess up this color. Which is probably not the greatest idea. Okay guys, so I am done and this is the finished look. I did like a full glam face so that I can just like really get the full effect of this foundation. And again, this is in the shade 65N and this is the Dior Backstage Face and Body Foundation. Now on camera, I mean, like the foundation looks pretty good to me. I mean, it doesn't look like it's like completely like that far off. And like it looks pretty decent. And it looks like it's kind of matte to me. Like it doesn't, of course it's not as matte as like the Fenty foundation, which is like my fave right now, but it does look like it is matte. Of course I have some glow on, so there's like some extra glow going on my skin right now. I think that I do like this. Now, this Dior Show foundation, there are like tons of shades. And even if like you may think like this foundation may be like one shade off you, they do have darker shades than this, and they also do have lighter shades than this. So for me, I mean, it looks okay, but like in person, I think that I could probably go like one shade probably lighter. But just like as in comparison, because I use my Fenty foundation like every single day now, and like it is like a flawless like match for me. But like when I look in the mirror, like I can tell like the shade, it is like a little like off. Like it's like a little like darker. It's like one shade darker. But I mean, this is still like a good match. You know, it looks like, it still looks good. Like, if I didn't have my Fenty foundation, like, this is definitely what I would use. Yeah, so I'm not gonna make this video too long. That's gonna be it for this video. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. Please make sure you subscribe to this channel for more videos. Let me know what you guys thought about this foundation in the comments below. Do you think that is a good match? Does it look good in my skin? If you're my skin tone, is this something that you would try or not? So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.